Okay, here ends another great run here at Bev Facey. You guys should all be extremely proud of yourselves. I know I am.
Exactly what Larry said. You stole my breath out there. I felt like I was watching my own children up
These
on that
are
stage.
My children. My saving grace. I see our calling
time. Okay, Jerry, we get it. Now we have to start taking down the set. Now remember, you need steel-toed boots and shin pads before you even attempt to touch the scaffolding.
Yes.
Remember, it's two people per 5-pound rod, and if we're lucky, we'll get done in about 20 minutes. Let's go!
Losing.
I've been training for this. We can still make it. Come on!
Matt, I said I wanted to win, not die first. Slow the heck down.
Yeah, Matt, seriously.
Must drive. Matt, go fast.
No, it's okay, it was just that hill. No need to stop.
Put the pedal to the metal.
Well, no, don't do that. The light's turning yellow. Hey, now it's turned red. Matt, slow down. The light is red.
Matt?
Matt, slow. Matt!
Stop, Matt!
Stop! Matt, Matt the light Matt. Is red! Matt, stop!
One day, 1 second, one crash. The lives of everyone at Bev Facey would change forever. Specifically, the lives of Larry Frank, Jerry Enns, and Colin Cruikshank would change the most. All three quit their jobs as they fell into the dark abyss of depression following the unexpected student deaths. They handled their grief in different ways. Larry decided he needed some alone time, so he left his wife and two kids and began mopping bathroom floors for a living. It left Colleen broken as she turned to spoon collecting to fill the void in her heart. Jerry, on the other hand, handled things differently. Not only was he diagnosed with clinical depression, but he became mute. He has not spoken since the evening of the student deaths. Because of their decreased income after the incident, Mr. Frank, Mrs. Cruikshank, and Mr. Enns all shared an apartment together and became roommates. They were best friends and inseparable. Until one night, everything changed once again.
Hey, Colleen, do you really miss it? What we had at Facey, you know, our old jobs, love, the memory?
Of course I do, Larry, but I can't bring myself to go back there. Not after what happened. It's far too painful for my heart to bear. But Larry, what we had there is gone now, and it's gone forever, and it's just us now, and I'm completely fine with that. But get some rest. You've got a big day tomorrow, and those toilets aren't gonna clean themselves.
Yeah, I guess you're right. All right, good night, guys.
Good night, Blair. Good night, Jer.
Larry.
Carmelina.
Jerry.
Wake up.
Wake up!
Jerry!
Wake up!
Wake up!
Wake up!
Larry!
Wake up,
Larry. Jerry!
Wake up!
Wake up!
Wake up!
Wake up!
Wake up!
Wake up!
Larry.
Wake up!
Wake up!
Colleen!
What do you want with us?
Who are you?
Ask us who we were. We are the ghosts of your former students. Drama past.
Drama present.
Drama future.
We have come to show you what once was, what is, and what will become if you do not return to the Facey Fine Arts program.
We can't return to Facey! After what happened to you guys, no way!
You seem jumpy, Larry. But I know you will settle down in due time, once we show you what your drama program has become. You used to be happy, and now all you do is cry and clean toilets.
Hey! Let him do what he wants! That chapter of our lives is over! We are never going back to that Facey program!
What about you, Colleen? How's your spoon collection? Want to know what the void in your heart can be filled by? Your students. They love you and miss you. You need help, Jerry? Just wait till you see what your sets have become since you departed. Follow me, teachers. Follow me.
I know this place. We used to teach here.
That's right.
Look, those are our kids. Look at them. They're playing all their favorite games.
Crossover if you think drama is so totally awesome.
I know!
Crossover if you never want this to end. Oh, look. They're having so much fun.
They were.
And I will show you what they have now become. Look closely. Where are we? Look at what things have become. Do you remember your dear costumer, Cynthia Silby? They now call her Cynthia Homely. She's lost all her fashion sense. In the most recent production of Guys and Dolls, they were wearing bikini tops and mini skirts. Okay, Cynthia, what era is this from? Definitely 2013.
Oh no! Well, that's not too bad. Well, we can do without her.
Perhaps. But what about your dear Allison Herder? One unfortunate day after an after-school rehearsal changed my life and career forever. I was walking in the Facey parking lot when Zach Hilt swerved and he did this to me. Yes, Jerry, Colleen, and Larry, I'm a quadriplegic. Perhaps Zach and choreograph the shows. Oh, stop the horror! I can't take any more. This is too much for my poor soul to bear. Wait. It gets much worse. Lots of the students have lost sight of who they are and have begun living the lives of their characters. Look closely.
So you got the goods? I hear you're the best in LA. Of course. Do you prefer liquid or chewable? Chewable, please.
Jeff, what are you doing? Those are my clothes.
Leave me alone! I do hair! Day after day.
Shut up, Jeff, you're a boy.
You don't know anything about me. Fashion is my life.
Oh, hey, Natasha. How did film school go?
Hey, great. Thanks for asking.
What kind of movies are you in? Have I seen you in anything?
Yeah. Probably not. So, like, indie films?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I guess you could say that.
Well, yeah, because me and my mom really wanted to go see one.
Maybe you could do that if you're into romance and things that are a little edgy.
Well, what's the movie called?
Busty Beige, Natasha Takes Over. It's a romance.
Oh.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, cool. Well.
Good job.
Help! I'm dying. Please, I think I have the measles.
Just ignore her, guys. She's just getting a little bit too much into her role.
No. I need help. I have so much to live for.
Left her to die!
Spare change? Any spare change? Or I'm an orphan. Noel.
Thou art as loathsome as a toad!
That will make it. Pow! By cheating!
Drama yet to come. Here to show you what will plague the halls of Beth Facey if you do not act quickly.
Who is that?
Is she new here?
I've never seen her before.
Oh, it's just a dream. Oh, just a dream. Oh, what was it? Oh! Matt, alive. Oh, and Brenna alive too. Oh, and is, oh, Cole, still alive, all alive. Oh crap, I'm late for the drawings.
Will you do the fandango?
Thunderbolts and lightning, very, very frightening me.
Galileo! Galileo!
Galileo! Galileo
Figaro!
Magnifico!
I'm just a poor boy, nobody loves me.
He's just a poor boy from a poor family. Spending his life with his monsters and teeth.
Easy come, easy go, will you let me go?
He's still alive, no, we will not let him go. Let him go!
He's still alive, we will not let you go.
Let him go!